Welcome back. We've seen some early drawings, but tonight we now officially know what the University of Kansas new football stadium will look like.
Looks pretty from here. The university released its plans for the KU Gateway District in a big ceremony on campus. Fox 4's Jonathan Ketz is live at KU to tell us how that project hopes to transform the north side of campus. Jonathan?
Kevin and John, it looks pretty good from where we're at, too, as I overlook David Booth Memorial Stadium. A good shot of the football field behind us, but we know it's going to change a lot in the next 2 years. There is a lot of buzz about this $300 million project that they've announced, and construction's going to start soon in December of this year, right after the football season's over. Here's the look at plans for the new football stadium, narrated by alumnus and NFL announcer Kevin Harlan.
The Gateway District. And the new David Booth Kansas Memorial Stadium.
Athletic Director Travis Goff says the new district will serve as the primary north entry point to the campus, feeding to the Jayhawk Welcome Center, where leaders held Tuesday's ceremony.
It will serve truly as KU's front porch for prospective students, student athletes, alumni, fans, community members. So many constituents.
Goff says there will also be a significant renovation of the Anderson Family Football Complex, an entirely new west side, new north bowl, and a new look above the highest level of seating.
Elevated kind of poles, if you will, that you see in the renderings is the lighting for the project, for the stadium. So it literally lights the field for afternoon and evening games. It also, from a design perspective, harkens a little bit with the landscape of our great state. When you think about wheat and you think about tall grass, giving the visual of that from an aesthetic perspective.
Among the other things fans and foes apparently want to know about is Wi-Fi connectivity. Travis Goff, the athletic director, says that we hear you when it comes to the problems at the current stadium, and they are hopefully going to be fixed in the future. By the way, the renovations are expected to be complete in August of 2025, so 2 years from now, hopefully in time for the football season at KU at that time. John?
Jonathan Ketz, live in Lawrence tonight. John, thanks.